memos, Manny's, Manny's Monday memos. Manny's Monday memos, Manny's, Manny's Monday memos. Manny's Monday memo, ho. Manny's Monday memo, ho. All right, so my girl Sarah, who watches Manny's Monday memos, she put in her submission of what topic she wanted me to talk about. And remember, you can always do this. So Sarah said she is fed up of you men treating we women like we're dumb. Specifically, she and her friends keep coming across some instances where men really just need to shut the hell up and leave she and her friends alone. For example, she was pumping gas the other day, and some man walked by her and said, "Oh yeah, make sure you don't put the diesel one in there. It's the green one over there to the far right." Now, anybody who's ever been to a gas station knows the diesel one is way different than regular, premium, unleaded, all that type of gas. So why in the world did he feel the need to tell her not to grab the diesel? You only grab diesel if you have a diesel truck or some other vehicle that needs it. So why did she feel the need, or excuse me, why did he feel the need to tell her that? Insulting her intelligence? Trying to spit game? Who knows? But either way it goes, it came off as him being rude to her. So she really was just like, you know, I'm really fed up of men that keep trying we women as though we're stupid, as though we're less than. And she's tired of the sexism. So today we are talking about sexism. And many of you subconsciously suffer from this sexism. It's either generational, it has to do with your spiritual beliefs, it has to do with a lot of things. But either way it goes, it has to stop. So someone like Sarah doesn't want a man to tell her or to insult her intelligence and act as though she has no common sense. Of course, when you go to the gas station, everybody knows the diesel is typically green. Some gas stations I've even seen it yellow. So it just depends on where you are. So let's not insult any more intelligence. Some of us women do actually give a damn to learn about things that are typically male related. For example, some of us women know how to change a tire, me. Some of us know how to check our oil, me. Some of us know how to replace our wiper fluid, me. Some of us know how to do several things when it comes to a vehicle. So don't assume that we are all just, "Oh, a man can do it for me." Nope, 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 nope. I take pride in doing something myself and not having to pay somebody to do it for me. If I'm paying somebody, it's either one, I don't know how, or two, I just don't want to do it. So don't sit there and assume that somebody like Sarah, who's an empowered woman, someone who is independent, doesn't know what she's doing. She doesn't want her intelligence to be insulted. If anything, she wants you to challenge her intelligence. She wants you to stimulate her brain cells, and she wants you to create conversation that she's typically not having with some of the males around her. So why don't you try to do that for once rather than insulting her? Remember, not all of us women want to be in the kitchen. Some of us can be in the kitchen, and you're going to be in the kitchen too, because that's called a partnership. Some of us don't want to just cook and clean and raise the kids. We want to cook, clean, raise the kids, and have a career, just like you are going to help us do. I'm not going to do this all by myself, because we are a pair. We our partnership. So let's not sit here and keep on that stereotypical sexist mindset of a woman should do this, a woman shouldn't do that, or women don't know how to do this, or women don't know how to do that. So I understand where Sarah's coming from, because I've been in predicaments before where a man has said something and I've literally gone, "What the hell are you talking about? Like, what kind of females do you think you're dealing with?" A lot of we women, we don't do well with sexist comments. Some women, they're okay with it because they also have sexist comments themselves. I'm not saying we women are perfect, but you need to be more aware of what you're saying, how you're saying it, and who you're saying it to. Because remember, at the end of the day, if you're trying especially to get at a woman, if you're trying to have her notice you coming off sexist, that's not the way to do it in any way, shape, or form. I understand that men are like, "Well, I'm supposed to be the head of the household. I'm supposed to be like, you know, strong-minded and blah, 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 blah." That doesn't mean putting your woman down in the process. And it doesn't mean to have a sexist mindset in any way, shape, or form. So let's do a better job of addressing women, especially in public places that we don't know. Let's not have these stupid comments that come off very sexist and insult someone's intelligence. Let's have inviting conversations, or let's talk about something that makes her happy. Let's not sit here and insult women like Sarah and have her frustrated enough to where she's like, Manny, I'm gonna need you to talk about this because I'm getting fed up. I'm more than just an object. I am more than just a piece of meat. I need men to understand that I actually do have something going on up here. So, me being the person I am, Sarah actually does have something going on up here along with many other women. So stop insulting a woman's intelligence. Stop talking down to them. Stop treating them as though they are less than you. I am not less than anybody, baby. And neither is Sarah, and neither are many other women out there. So let's do a better job of being respectful, okay? Now have a good Monday.